everyone. Welcome to Lex Talk, World Talk show presented by ClickAway Creators. Today we have Mr. Raghavendra Verma, who has over 20 years of experience as a corporate legal leadership. His gamut of experience includes cross-border M&A, privacy laws, cybersecurity, strategy, compliance, contract negotiations, litigation, and risk management. In a career spanning of 20 years, Raghavendra delivered business-driven legal strategy at global, regional, and national levels across several industry verticals. Currently, he is serving IZON as group head, legal, compliance, and as corporate secretary. IZON Group is into IT and ITs and have business operations in 29 countries across Africa, Middle East, and India as well. Hello, Mr. Raghavendra. How are you?
I am fine. Thank you. Thank you very much, Bharti. And thanks for your nice introduction.
Pleasure is all ours, Mr. Raghavendra. So we're really excited to know about you and about your journey as a legal professional. So let's just get started with that first.
Yeah, thanks, Bharti. So I will start from my background. I born and brought up in the Samastipur district of India. After graduation, I moved to Delhi. I did my LLB and the company secretaryship from Delhi. I started my career as the junior legal officer and slowly, steadily kept climbing on the ladder, now serving ISON as a group head legal compliance and company secretary. During my around 20 years professional life, I served various industries starting from the manufacturing to real estate to mining, IT, ITS and the BPO. So in almost all my company in the previous assignment in the current assignment, I was instrumental in implementing various new ideas, processes in almost all of the companies. I developed unique and innovative compliance process, corporate governance process across organization, covering Africa, India, and Middle East, that eventually led us to win one best corporate governance award in Kenya. During this entire my journey, I acquired various companies across globe, few to mention here, Dubai, Egypt, South Africa, Sub-Saharan Africa. Why I'm mentioning here that I am not taking any outside external consultant anywhere. I built in-house capability and knowledge to execute this transaction. I believe in taking risk, and most of the time risk is rewarding for me. If sometimes it's not, then it's taught me a nice lesson. As far as personal is concerned, my hobby is writing and reading. I do service as a volunteer of Art of Living. Yeah, that's it.
That is wonderful, Mr. Raghavendra. You actually are doing a lot of things together, which is great, and I'm sure it must be really hard to manage. We're really interested in knowing about your memorable case, the most memorable case, and if you have any key takeaways from there.
Bharti, it's just unfair to one memorable case. It's 20 years of a life, a career, professional career span. And so many cases are there, but I just try to mention one landmark case that is one of the country in Africa, and that really defined the BPO industry in Africa. So that's why I wanted to mention here. We have been in the BPO sector. Labor Ministry, and one of our client is the telecommunication industry. Labor Ministry issued a notice to us back 2013-14 story is to implement minimum wage of the telecommunication industry. The impact on us was the hundreds of millions of dollars. We objected, we showed them every proof that we are BPO. They did not agree with us. Then finally moved to the High Court, and after a few days, they agreed to withdraw the notice and agreed with us. This was one of the landmark cases there that defined BPO industry in that particular country. My key takeaway from that was, even if the opposite party is powerful, maybe it's government, but you must fight for our cause. Yeah, Bharti.
Thank you so much. As you mentioned that there's not only one case. I mean, obviously it's an unfair thing to do to be just asking about one. I would really love to know another one as well. I'm sure you would be very much interested in telling us about that.
Yeah, Bharti. So another case I can mention name here is of the Kenya. So in our industry, when client outsource one of the business to vendors, they also transfer the employee to the vendors. And this rebadging of the employee is very complicated. It's required a lot of preparation, a lot of law, procedural law, substantial law is involved. And they did a minor mistake and employee went and filed a case against them and employee won that case. And this again, the million of dollar was involved. So my takeaway from that case was that while applying legal principle is fine, adhering to the due process of the law is having same importance. I'm just short, I'm keeping short because I know the time is so.
Thank you so much. And I'm sure there are a lot more cases that you would like to discuss with us, but we have a limited time and I'm sure we can, you know, schedule another interview for the most memorable cases, the part. How can an in-house counsel add more value to his organization by being a true business partner? It would be really great if you can enlighten us about this particular topic.
Yeah, this is a very pertinent question these days, Bharti.
Thank you.
And see, we lawyer generally, business, see we lawyer as a back office job and seek help from us in the technical expertise like litigation, risk management, employment law, and compliance with the corporate governance. But in-house lawyers can act and very well act as a commercial business partner. We have the special skill that is a strategic and the analytical skill. It is in our blood. So in-house counsel must act as a commercial business partner. They need to be a member of the business team and they should focus on how to grow the business. Lawyers should learn how to speak the business language, need to be part of the business team and understand their challenges and the battle. And provide general counsel, not in just legal sense, proper business sense. Keeping balance between law and practicality is paramount. As you know, sometimes lawyers say that, no, we can't do this business. This is wrong. Law is not prohibiting. Law is prohibiting this. So I will advise to lawyers, don't say no to any business prospect. You should be innovative. You find out the solution, provide the solution to the business, be a facilitator to the business, not as a roadblock. At the same time, I will advise, balancing risk and reward is equally important. So you just weigh the weightage between risk and reward. One last point I want to add here, becoming team player is very important. Generally what happened, Bharti, when people come to the legal team with the problem, and we need to resolve that, but lawyer can take a proactive step there and they can go ahead and search for the root cause and address that root cause, resolve that root cause. This will really help your organization a lot. Collaboration with the different department is key here.
Thank you, Raghavendra. It was wonderful insight. What is now, as we were talking about BPO in the second question when it came to the most memorable case, so where is the impact of technology advancement on BPO industry and particularly in-house lawyers?
Yeah, so you know technology is changing everything now and that this COVID is really enhanced the value of the technology. We are talking on the right now.
Right.
Through technology process.
Right.
And same thing is happening with the BPO. The landscape of the BPO industry has undergone into a sea change. Technology advancement has taken the customer experience to the next level. And you know, customer experience is the battleground where business flourishes and the fall. Few technology like automation and robotics are changing the way we live and work. It brought digital information of the process, transformation of the process and empower agents. It is enhancing productivity and accuracy in the process and what is lead to the happy customer. Similarly, advanced analytics and the artificial intelligence can analyze the customer behavior, recommend product and the service by analyzing that customer behavior. Data interpretation and analysis is becoming so easier nowadays. So in fact, now BPO industry is not being seen as it used to be as low cost service provider by client, but basically they are seen as a valued partner who brings value to the brand and the happier customer. As far as the impact on the legal profession is concerned, I would like to say here that artificial intelligence is changing the legal profession in the big way. Artificial intelligence, with the help of the data analytics, blockchain, are changing the life. Nowadays, contract drafting, reviewing of the contract, as well as the due diligence is being done by the artificial intelligence. You know, research work is done by the data analytics these days. You all know that.
Yes, yes, absolutely.
Yeah. Digitization and storage of the case law, statute and regulation is so easier now. The smart contract, the concept of the smart contract is now a reality due to blockchain. So I am seeing the future, and I can tell you with the guarantee, in within the next few years, there would be a revolution in the practice of the law. And in-house lawyers should adopt and embrace these changes, otherwise they will be left behind. So I can add few things here. There are many positive impact of the technology, but we are seeing that some negative aspect, and I would like to mention here that the lower level legal job like paralegal, legal secretary job would not be available in the future. That will be done by the technology. And one more thing, however, technology is empowering the people, but they are also empowering the fraudster, the cyber crime and the cyber fraud. People are doing by using the technology, and the legal community has to think now how to fix the liability and how to enforce the law in the case, the accused in one country and victim in another country. How to enforce the law, which country law will apply, how to fix the liability. So that is going to be a big challenge for the whole legal community to come out with some solution.
Absolutely. I couldn't agree more with you on all the points that you have put forward per se. As we are talking to a very experienced person and a very experienced legal expert, so I'm actually talking to all the viewers right now, and this is for my viewers. I'm asking this question on your behalf that, Mr. Raghavendra, what is your advice to the legal professionals in this dynamic corporate world?
Yeah. So, Bharti, the legal profession is going to be they're going to happen a big change in the legal profession. The amount and complexity of the law, regulation, risk, together with the challenge posed by the global market, is going to play an important role. And the perceived strategic importance of the in-house lawyer is going to increase because of the complexity of the compliances and changing the regulatory landscape. As we lawyer, I mentioned earlier also, we have the unique quality. We can think the strategy, we have the analytic skill in our blood. So one professional I will advise them should leverage on that. Be a value creator, should be a business partner, and always be a solution provider. You should come with the solution. You should not let the law, people think that the law is a barrier for the furtherance of the business interest. Adoption of technology is must, should learn technology. And one main basic point is develop the leadership. And what is the meaning of leadership in the organization perspective, I would like to say. You should have, and you have, because you graduated from the law school, you have the deep knowledge, technical knowledge of your subject. But at the same time, you should have the broad knowledge of all the department of the organization. That will build your credibility in the organization. People will take you seriously. I know this transition is not going to be easy. This is a huge task. You have to take a big leap there. But there is a choice. I don't think there is a choice. Young professionals have to learn the business language. But one main thing, many times, many circumstances will come. I will phrase my language in different way. at any point of time, you should not compromise on your value system integrity while you are providing the solution to the business. That would be my advice.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Mr. Raghvendra. And it was lovely knowing about your journey. And at the same time, I'm sure the viewers are going to love this interview in terms of knowledge and the kind of experience that you have, that you're bringing to the table it's really inspiring. So thank you so much for spending time with us and sharing some amazing experiences. We really look forward to having a chat with you again in the future on maybe some other trending topics in the international legal industry, Mr. Raghvendra.
And thank you very much, Bharti. Thank you very much, Bharti. Sorry.
No, please.
I would like to thank LexTalk because the people brought a platform where lawyers can exchange their view, share their views with the legal fraternity and the outside world. This is amazing. Thank you all people.
Thank you so much. It is lovely getting a compliment from you, sir. And we just hope that the love that we are getting, it's actually really overwhelming. I'll be very honest with you. But this response that we're receiving, it's making us so positive. And I'm sure that it's just the starting. It's just the starting and we have a long way to go.
Wish you all
and
the best.
If we have you guys to support us, people like you, then nothing's going to stop us.
Yeah. My best wishes with you. All the best.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And I'm sure that we'll be meeting again, maybe on a really... other trending topic, maybe we'll choose a topic and we'll be reaching out to you with that. And for our viewers, if you like this chat with Mr. Raghvendra, please like and share this video, and also please subscribe to Clickaway Creators YouTube channel to appreciate what we do, and you have more coming from our industry leaders. Thank you so much again. This is Bharti for LexTalk signing off. Take care, bye-bye, and please stay safe.